नमस्ते एवरीबडी, दिस इज सुशील कुमार सिंह फ्रॉम केयरिंग विद कलर्स। सो इवत्तिन वंदु ट्रेनिंग सेशन अल्ली मॉड्यूल 3 अल्ली नोट करुव टॉपिक्स गळु हीगिवे: फोनिक्स, पंक्चुएशन्स, सिमिली मेटाफर, पर्सोनिफिकेशन। विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट ऑल दिस टॉपिक्स। विल बी लुकिंग एट डिफरेंट ट्रांजैक्शन आइडियाज एज वेल। सो इन दिस सेशन we will be going through each of those topics in these four checkpoints. So first checkpoint would be about the concept, where we will be discussing about that concept and we will be defining the concept and we'll be understanding more about the concept. Under transaction ideas, we will be discussing transactional ideas for classroom. These can be classroom activities where teachers can directly take them to the classroom. Under what did we learn, we will have a small recap of what we have been discussing so far. And fun with English is a section where we will have fun with English, obviously, by playing some games like riddles, questionnaire, puzzles, and so on.
Hi, good morning, Sushil.
Hey, good morning, Vivek. How are you?
Fine, thank you, Sushil. How about you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Sushil, I have a concern. Will you please help me?
Sure. What is it?
As this is a lockdown situation, online classes are going on for my daughter, Sushil.
Okay.
There, they teach her BAT bat as b, a, t and all.
Uh-huh.
But you know, I don't know much about that. How can I teach her and help her to understand this, Sushil?
I think I understand your problem, Vivek. The solution that you are looking for is nothing but phonics. So phonics is what the teacher is teaching your daughter. But to discuss more about phonics, I think my friend Kriti will be the best person to do that. So I'll give you her phone number to you. So can you call her up and ask your concern to her? She'll define
yes,
more about phonics to you.
Yes, Sushil. Please give her phone number.
Sure. Here it is.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Good morning, ma'am. It is Vivek here.
Hello, Vivek.
I just had a talk with Sushil about my problem.
Yeah, yeah. Sushil just called me and he told me about your concern.
Okay.
So, yes, as Sushil mentioned to you, it's all about phonics, Vivek.
Okay. What is phonics, ma'am?
Vivek, phonics is a method used to teach reading and writing of English by developing awareness to hear, identify, and manipulate the units of sounds. The main aim of phonics is to enable the learners to break the words by sounding them out while reading and writing.
Okay. Then why should we use phonics, ma'am?
So to say, I can say basics of any language learning depends on the four major skills. They are listening, speaking, reading, and writing. In short, we can call them as LSRW. The okay. Basics of LSRW can be achieved through phonics easily. This phonics will help you in identifying the alphabets. Then it helps you to pronounce them using the sounds associated with each letter or combination of certain letters. Then, using that knowledge of sounds, we can read the text as well as writing it. So this will help in language learning process.
Okay.
To begin with, we have to identify the 26 letters and reproduce their sounds. After that, we have something called as 18 special sounds produced with a combination of two letters. Then we can continue with two-letter words, three-letter words, blends, digraphs, sight words, and magic keywords.
Oh, Kriti ma'am, but in my school days, I learned that there are only 26 letters in English alphabet. Then how come 44 sounds?
Vivek, as you said, our English alphabet has 26 letters. And as I said, there is something called as 18 special sounds, which is a combination of two letters. So okay. That is why it is 44 sounds. Do you want to know which are these 44 sounds?
Yes, ma'am. I'm eagerly interested to learn this.
Sure, sure. So let me take you to Angel of Sound, Nisarga, who will let us know about these 26 sounds first.
Sure. Let us start with the letter A. A sounds A, and action for this sound would be A, 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 like an ant moving on your arm. A sounds A, A, A. You all can repeat after me. A sounds A, A, A. Then we have B. B sounds B. For this, action would be pretend like you're holding a bat and trying to hit a ball with the sound. B, B, B. B sounds B, B, B. Then we have C. C sounds K. Think that there is a crow cawing around you with the sound K, K, K. You all can repeat after me. C sounds K, K, K. Then we have D. D sounds D. For that, you have to pretend like you are banging on the drum with the sound D, D, D. You all can repeat after me. D sounds D, D, D. Then we have E. E sounds A. For this, you have to pretend like you are breaking the egg and trying to put it on the pan using your hands with the sound A, A, A. You all can repeat after me. E sounds A, A, A. Then we have F. F sounds F. If you're not able to hear my voice, it's F. You just have to drag that sound a bit. It would sound F. For this, think that you're holding a balloon which is inflated. When it starts deflating, it would sound F. You all can repeat after me. F sounds F. Then we have G. G sounds G. Action for this sound would be this G, 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 like water is gurgling down the plug hole. You all can enact with me. G sounds G, G, G. Then we have H. For this, you have to hold your palm against your face and try saying it. H sound should come from your stomach. You all can do it with me. H sounds. Then we have I. I sounds E. Just think that there is an ink pot which is just fell on the mouse, and that mouse is making a sound E, E, E. I sounds E, E, E. Then we have J. J sounds J. For this, you have to pretend like you're holding jellies in your hands, and those jellies are juggling with the sounds J, J, J. You all can repeat after me. J sounds J, J, J. Then we have K. K sounds K. For this, you have to pretend like you are flying a kite with the sound K, K, K. You all can repeat after me. K sounds K, K, K. Then we have L. For this, you have to pretend like you are holding a lollipop and trying to eat that lollipop with the sound L. If it is not clear, it's la. You just have to drag that sound a bit. It would sound L. You all can do it with me. L sounds L. Then we have M. For this, just think that you're very hungry and there are variety of food in front of you. And how would you react? You would be reacting like mmm. You all can do it with me. M sounds mmm. Then we have N. For this, think that there is an aeroplane which is flying with the sound N. You all can do it with me. N sounds N. Then we have O. O sounds O. It's not O, it's O. If you're not getting that sound, just point your finger towards your throat and try saying it. O, O, O. O sounds O. Action for this sound would be O, O, O. If you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm just trying to turn on and off the switch. You all can do it with me. O sounds Then we have P. P sounds P. Pretend that, think that there is a beautiful birthday cake in front of you and you are trying to blow the candle on it with the sound pa, pa, pa. You all can repeat after me. P sounds pa, pa, pa. Then we have Q. For this, you have to pretend like a duck and do the sound qua, qua, qua. You all can repeat after me. Q sounds qua, qua, qua. Then we have R. Think that there is a puppy which is trying to rip off the rag with the sound rrr. R sounds rrr. Then we have S. S sounds s. You might have already guessed the sound. It is a hissing sound of the snake. S sounds s. Then we have T. T sounds t. For this, you have to think like you are watching a tennis game and the ball is moving from one court to another court with the sound ta, 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 ta. You all can repeat after me. T sounds ta, 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 ta. Then we have U. For this, you have to pretend like you're opening an umbrella with the sound a. U sounds a. You all can do the action with me. U sounds a, a. Then we have V. V sounds V. Even if you don't know the driving, that's okay. Just pretend like drivers for a few seconds and drive a van with the sound V, V, V. V sounds V, V, V. Then we have W. W sounds V. For this, pretend like wind is blowing on your open hands with the sound V, V, V. You all can do it with me. W sounds wah, wah, wah. Then we have X. For this, you have to pretend like you're taking a picture using the camera with the sound x, x, x. You all can repeat after me. X sounds x, x, x. Then we have Y. Y sounds ya. For this, you have to think like you're holding a yummy yogurt. To eat that yogurt, you need a spoon, right? The sound would be, you'll be eating a yogurt with the sound ya. Y sounds ya, ya, ya. Y sounds ya, ya, ya. Then we have Z. Z sounds z. You might be familiar with this sound. It's the sounding, buzzing sound of the bee. Sound of letter Z would be z. Z sounds z. These are the 26 sounds of the alphabet. I hope you all enjoy that.
Thank you, dear angel of sound. But you have just told us about 26 sounds. But what about the rest of the sounds?
Those sounds are called special sounds. Those will be introduced by my friend Shri. She's an angel of special sounds.
So, hi everyone. So I'm the angel of special sounds. Thank you, Alphabet Angel. And now let's start with the special sounds. So as you can see the board, which tells about we are going to learn the special sounds. So as it is told earlier, we have 18 special sounds. So it's the combination of two letters. So let's see one by one. So on the first go, we have the H ending letters, the combination of H ending letters. So you can see S and H. So the firstly, how we are going to learn the special sounds is, first we are going to see the combination of letters. The second one would be the sound. The third one would be the action. And the fourth one would be the two or three examples of the particular sound. So on the first go, we have S and H. So SH gives us the sound sh. So we have told the sound as sh and the action would be sh. And the examples are, you can have it as shirt, shark, shine, as such. Now let's move on with the next H ending word or the sound, that is T and H. So the combinations are T and H. Here we have two sounds coming from the same letters. One is th and the other one is d. The sound is th and d, and the action would be th and d. So we term it as th, and inside is th. And examples, you can take it as thirst or 33, or the numbers whichever comes from th, 31, 32, examples as such. So let's move on to the next one with the other h ending. We have w and h. So here comes the sound w. You can use the action as whistling w, or you can also use as the action as what. So the examples, as I told already, it can be whistle or what. We have still more, and the last one of it, H ending sound, that is C and H. The letters are C and H. It will give us the sound ch. It will give us the sound ch, and the action would be like the train chugging. So ch, ch, ch. The action is that, and you can have the examples below of the each and every card. You can see it. You can be telling it as chair, champ, child, children. So many examples as such. Now we are moving for the next ending, that is E ending sounds. We are moving for E ending sounds. First one is double E. Here you can see there are two the same letters, that is double E. Whenever the sound is ending with, or the word ending with E, we go with the previous one. See, there are two E's. Whenever E is at the end, we go with the first letter sound. So first letter is E, obviously we'll take it as E. So the action is E. So whenever the photographer says cheese, say cheese. Yeah, that the same action you can use it for this double E. E, and the examples can be C, teeth, and also breathe. So that can also be used. So next we can take it as other E ending word, that is I and E. So here you can see it as the first letter is I. So we spell it as I. The action can be used it as we are adjusting the tie. So adjusting the tie would be the action, like this, I, and you can sound it as I. The examples would be tie, pie, that can be used. So the other E ending sound is O and E. So O and E gives us O sound. You can, here you can use the example of showing the action of a toe and tell the action for with the toe. That can be given, and the examples would be toe, foe. Foe is just in synonym of enemy. So that can be used. The other E ending sound would be U and E. So as I said earlier, you can take it as the first letter sound. Whenever E comes at the end, you will choose the first letter sound. So it is U. The both the letters give us the sound as U, and the action would be pointing. And like whenever we point U, the same action can be used, U. And the examples can be taken as rescue. And we can take it as blue, value. Now we'll see about the R ending sounds. So here you can see the combination as E and R will together give us the sound R. So we have seen in the mixers sounding as R. So the same action can be used here, arr. So the sound is arr and the action is this, arr. And we have examples as mixer, and we have the cricket term sixer also. So that can be used. The next R ending word would be, or the sound would be OR. So this is very easy, and we can show the action of orange. So we usually do this for an apple or orange. We can use it for the same action. So R, the sound is R and the action is like this. You can have the example as orchid, orange, and many more. the last R ending sound would be A, R. So this is A and R gives us the sound as R, and the action would be like R. Whenever you go to the dentist, the dentist says, please open your mouth and say R. The same thing can be used, R. So open your mouth and say R, and the action is the opening the mouth. Examples would be car, park, anything like that. And we are going to a different combination of letters now. We have done with the ending R ending sounds, E ending sounds, and H ending sounds. Now we are looking for N and G. So the correct sound of this would be just ng, but it is most of the times it is misspelled as ng. It is not ng, it is just ng. So we can have the examples as kink, sink, song, singer. We can have many more examples like that. And we have CK as the next one. So the sound will give as k. So we can use the action of kicking. So kicking the ball. So that can be used for the action. K, k. And examples would be kick, sick, pick, and many more. Now we have the already used one, Q, U. The alphabet Angel also told about this. Q, U. So this would be, the action would be qua, qua, qua. The sound is qua and action is this. And you can have the examples as quick. And the most recent one, what we are hearing nowadays is quarantine. So that can be on also an example for this. And next we are ending with the I ending sounds that will come up to AI. So AI. So whenever we like we suffer pain, we say, or in the pain, like a pain. So whenever we feel pain, we say a. The same thing can be used. A will be the action and the sound. And you can have the examples as pain, paint, or rain, and many more. And next one would be O and I. See, whenever our friend is a little far away, so we say oi. Yeah, that can be taken as the action. The sound is oi and the action is oi. And examples can be taken as oil, point, and things. Now we are having a double letter and a very interesting one. So this double letter gives us the two sounds. One is O and the other one is O. One is the short one and the other one is the lengthy one. O and the other one, O. So the action would be like you have seen the cuckoo coming out of the clock and say, O, O. The same action can be taken, O, O. So the examples can be cool, pool, and moon as well. The last and the favorite one of mine is OU. It sounds ow and the action is like ow. So whenever somebody pinches or whenever you get hurt, we say ow. The same action can be used for this also. The sound is ow and the action is ow. So hope the sounds and the actions would help you. Thank you.
Thank you, dear Angel of Special Sound. That was very interesting. What do you say, Vivek?
Wow. Now I understood the relationship between letters and sounds, ma'am. Thank you very much, Angel of Sounds.
Okay. So, Vivek, have you heard about vowel and consonant?
Yes, I know. In my school days, I have heard that there are 5 vowels and 21 consonants.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. So now, after we have learned about sounds, we have to further proceed with forming two-letter words, right?
Okay.
So first, I would be taking a combination of vowel and consonant. We call it as VC words. After that, we would be going ahead with adding one consonant before, making it CVC words. That is consonant, vowel, consonant, word. So just imagine I am giving you a vowel as A And which consonant would you add and make it a two-letter word?
If I select A as a vowel and N as a consonant sound, I think it will be N.
Very good. Okay. Just imagine I'm giving you a vowel and consonant combination as AD. Which consonant would you add before and make it a three-letter word?
If this is AD, I'd like to add a consonant letter S, which states sad, ma'am. But I'm very happy to learn now. I'm not sad now.
Okay. So, I know because of online classes, your daughter might be bored to sit at one place all the time. So, let's yes. make her move a little. Okay.
Okay.
So, as you can see on your screen now, just like that, you can draw it on the floor. The same pattern can be drawn on the floor, where each box will have a CVC word, a three-letter word. Okay?
Okay.
All that she has to do is to start from the starting point. Then every time she jumps forward, she has to read the word that is there in that box. For example, from starting box, if she jumps forward, she would reach the word sat. When she reaches there, she has to read it as at, sat. Only then she will be able to hop forward.
Wow, this is an interesting transaction idea, ma'am.
Yeah, and then you can also create one vertical strip and an horizontal strip. Whereas in vertical strip, you can have all the consonants. And in the horizontal strip, you can have a VC word. All that you have to do is to move your horizontal strip of word to form three-letter words.
Oh, fine. This is very fine, ma'am.
Yeah. And along with that, however, I know you will be having newspapers at your home.
Yes.
You can cut out some pictures like dog, cup, car, mat, etc. And then you can form a flashcard of three-letter words for a dog, cup, car, mat, etc. and ask her to match them.
Okay. Yes. Kriti ma'am, hold for a while.
Yeah, sure, Vivek.
My doorbell is ringing. I need to see who is there.
Sure.
Oh,
sure.
Hi, Sushil.
Hi, Vivek.
Oh, please come in, Sushil. Very happy to meet you. Come in. Yeah. Sushil, till now, I was learning more about phonemes, sounds and all from Kruti ma'am. Please join us.
Sure. Even I wanted to know what was happening regarding the phonics discussion.
Okay.
Hey, Kriti, what's going on regarding phonics? What are you discussing?
Hey, Sushil. Till now, we were discussing about two-letter words, three-letter words, and 44 sounds. Now, we were just about to discuss about blends. Do you know what is blends?
No. What are blends?
Yeah. Blends are just a combination of two or three-letter words. And whenever you bring them together, it will sound, you will get to hear both the sounds of the letters. For example, B and L, when they're combined together, they form blur, as in black. And if you have, for example, C and L, it becomes clear, as in clap. Have you heard about digraphs? Digraphs are also like blends, the combination of two letters. But the only difference here between blends and digraphs is when two letters are combined, they produce a different sound, third sound. Like S and H together, they would form sh, as in sharp. And another example is C and H, as in chair. Now, I would like to ask you both a question. If S and H together is pronounced as sh, as in shar, what would be the sound of K and N together?
Sushil, do you know the answer?
No, Vivek. Do you have any idea?
Even I also don't know, Sushil. I'm very sorry.
Shall we take the help of our participants then?
Yes, let's ask our friends.
Sure. Teachers,
please help us out in answering to this question. Hey, Vivek, I can see that 60% of all our teachers have said the sound would be N.
Yeah, right.
Shall we go with that answer?
Yes, Sushi, let's pose this answer to Kruti ma'am and see what she said.
Okay. Hey, Kriti, I think the right answer would be N.
Yes, you're absolutely right. It is N, as in not, night, etc. I was thinking of creating some beautiful flowers. Okay. So here, what I would be doing is, I would be creating colorful flowers where the inner circle would rotate. And the petals would be having some blends and digraphs. So every time your daughter rotates it, then she will be forming new words with blends or digraphs. Hey, Sushi, do you use tissue rolls at your home?
Yes, I do.
What do you do after your tissues are over? What do you do with the roll?
I throw them away.
I don't think you need to throw it away next time, because I have some interesting idea for you. That is, you can create those reading rolls out of the tissue rolls. Okay, so here you can create a lot of blends and digraph rolls and use them for reading.
Hey, one second. But I also know some of the words. Like, let me just take an example of because. That's the word I use very frequently. But that does not actually hold up to what you have been saying about phonics right now. So what about the words like because?
As you said, you use that word frequently. The words that are used frequently in English are called as sight words. Most of these words do not follow the phonic rules, the sound rules. There are other examples also, like are, is, was, this, that, there, etc. Vivek, have I ever mentioned to you that I work with an organization called as Caring with Color?
Yes, Kruti ma'am. You had told me this earlier. And you also told me there are some activities going on there. What are those?
Yeah. We have been practicing phonics approach in the schools that we work closely. We have some beautiful and interesting results that we have got while we are using phonics to develop LSRW in the learners. To assess the learning level with each and every student, we have designed an assessment which will be conducted every month. And this assessment has four stages. And we conduct it on one-on-one basis. And we have seen a good improvement in their writing and reading.
Oh, fine, ma'am. Surely we will visit your organization and school one day.
Sure, Vivek.
But now, ma'am, as it is a lockdown situation and corona in and around, where could I get these resources to teach through phonics for my daughter?
Vivek, I had been referring to Pratham books. This has a wide range of simple stories and some interesting stories too. Okay. And I also refer to websites like Storyweaver, British Council, for more new ideas and informations. Along with that, I even have subscribed to some YouTube channels like Choo Choo TV, Coco Melon, etc. And CWC has a platform called as Teachopia, and there are a lot of activities available there.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for teaching me and knowing me about phonics.
Sure, Vivek.
Thanks. Now let us consolidate what we have learned so far. We have learned that phonics is a methodology used to teach English, where reading and writing is more emphasized along with speaking and listening. Here, the emphasis is given on the sound of a letter or combination of letters.
Hey, Sushil.
Yes, Vivek.
Come, let's go with the fun with English. I hope you're very fond of playing riddles, right?
I am.
Wait, I'll ask you a riddle this time. Would you try to answer it?
Sure, bring it on.
Okay, try it out. The riddle is like this. I am an English word. If you pronounce me correctly, then you are wrong. And if you pronounce me wrong, then you are right. Who am I?
If I pronounce you correctly, I'm wrong. If I pronounce you wrong, I'm right. I don't get it, Vivek.
Oh, fine. Don't scratch your head too much, Sushil. Our friends will help us this time. Friends, we request all of you to find out the answer in a chat box by giving the correct answer and predicting the riddle.
I think the answer to this is W-R-O-N-G, if wrong.
Yes. If I'm not wrong, the answer is wrong, Sushil.
It was a nice riddle, Vivek.
Oh, thank you, Sushil. And thank you, friends. But Sushil, You just came earlier. I didn't know what was the intention of coming to my house. What made you come here?
I'm so sorry. I forgot the reason that I visited your house. In fact, I wanted to borrow a book from you, Vivek.
Oh, is it? Come, I'll show you my library.
Hey, what is this? You call this a library, but you don't have a single book in your room. You know, a room without book is like a body without a soul.
Oh, Sushil, it was a nice example. You just used simile to compare a room without any books with a body with no soul by using the word like. Good. But Sushil, you know, I'll fill my room with books. I'm fond of writing more. A pen is mightier than sword, Sushil.
Oh, nice one, Vivek. You actually used a metaphor here. You just compared the strength of a pen to the strength of the sword. A nice one.
Yes, but Sushil, I want to learn more about simile and meta from your side. Will you please help me?
Sure. Okay. Let me show you how different or similar the metaphor and simile are.
Okay.
Here is a girl, and as I can see, she is tall. If I have to use a simile to describe this feature of hers to you, I would say she is as tall as a giraffe. I just compared the girl's height to the height of the giraffe. Mind you, I use the word as. But if I have to do it using a metaphor, I would say something like, the girl is a giraffe. Or I would say she is the giraffe of the class.
Oh, Sushil, do you remember we used to call you the giraffe of our class?
I do remember, Vivek. You haven't stopped calling me that yet.
Yes.
You know what? Similes and metaphors can also come in visual forms.
Okay.
Let me show you. So I recently got this image from a newspaper. What can you see here?
Sushil, I see a Renault on four tires and some body of the car above the head of rhinoceros. What's this?
Exactly. So this was an advertisement by a car company which wanted to convey that their car is very safe because it is as tough as a rhino.
And you know, yesterday I had another such example in a newspaper and I came to know this picture, Sushil.
Mm-hmm.
This visual metaphor very strongly convey that words are very strong than a gun or a grenade. Words have the power to kill the war. Words can kill.
Wow. It was nice. I even have one more for you.
Okay.
So this is from another advertisement. What can you see?
I see here a sunscreen lotion.
Exactly. So this is an actual advertisement of a sunscreen lotion where the company wanted to convey that our cream protects you from the sun. So as you can see, the giant sunscreen tube is literally protecting everybody from the sun.
This cream protects you from the sun.
Yes.
Sushil, till now we saw many visual metaphors and their captions. Mm-hmm. Here is an image for you, Sushil, for which I like you to give a creative caption using simile and metaphor. Can you try such one?
Do I have to caption this?
Yes.
I see a cone. It looks like an ice cream cone, but instead of a ice cream scoop, I see the image of a earth. I don't know. I can't come up with a caption for this. I don't know what to say.
No worries, Sushil. Our friends are always here to help us. Friends, will you please use a creative caption by using simile and metaphor and say what kind of image it is? Try to give that answer in a chat box.
One of my friends, Jyoti, has already helped me out by saying cool earth. And Nitin sir says melting earth. Pushpa ma'am says melting earth again. Okay.
Okay. Yes. Many of my friends are even telling global warming.
Yeah, looks like that. I see globe, says Lakshmi ma'am. The earth is melting like ice cream. Yes, yes. It is.
Using of like a simile is a wonderful imagination, and it's true, Sushil.
Yeah. Narasimha Murthy sir says, don't melt earth. That can be a nice message.
Yes.
Oh, world is like an ice cream and it melts.
Wonderful.
Everybody is saying melting earth. Earth is in our hand.
Yeah, they are using their wonderful creative ideas, Sushil.
Yeah. Nice captions from everybody. Thank you, teachers.
Thank you, friends.
Hey, it's my time to play a game with you, okay?
Yes, please.
Look at this image. Even I came up with some captions when I looked at this image. Teachers, I want even you, everybody, to look at this image now. So do you see the metaphor here, Vivek?
Yes, I see a picture here, but I can give wonderful caption for this, Sushil. In my opinion, shopping just a touch away would be fine for this.
Oh, that's a nice caption. Let me think. I can say work from home, shop from home.
Yours is also awesome, Sushil. But let me give one more answer. Click Mart would be mine.
Nice one. Yeah, because you click and you get your stuff. Very good. Yes. What about market in my phone then?
Oh, it's also fine. I'll go with another one, Sushil. From farms to phones will be suitable one for this.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. But don't you think my captions are that much more creative?
I think, but mine are a little bit better than you, Sushil. Don't feel bad.
Okay, let's do one thing. Rather than us quarreling between each other, teachers, help us out solve this issue. Which caption do you think suits best to this image? Do not answer in the chat section. This time, we will use the poll question. So a poll question will pop up on your screen right now. All you have to do is read all the captions and vote for the one that you feel suits best for the image. So there is no right or wrong question for this. It is your opinion. Yes. So the polls have ended. Vivek.
Yes, Sushil.
Even our teachers, they want to not side with any of us, either of us.
Yes.
So good job, teachers. Thank you for showing love to both of us.
Thank you, teachers. Thank you for being impartial.
Yes. Okay. So this is my chance of riddling you. So Vivek, get ready for a riddle from my side.
Sure, Sushil.
So this is my riddle. Let me see if I can answer to this.
Okay.
Teachers, please play along. I can sizzle like a bacon and I come from an egg. I have plenty of black bone, but lack a good leg. I peel like an onion, but I'm always whole. I'm long like a flagpole, yet I fit in a hole. Who am I?
Sushil, I can see some words like egg, backbone, hole, onion, but I'm unable to predict. Wait. By the way, I have my friend here by name Tunga. She is very good at riddles, Sushil. I'll ask her. Tunga, will you please try to predict the answer?
This riddle seems a little difficult for me, Vivek. No, I don't know. But I can do one thing. Let us ask our friends. Friends, here is a riddle for you all. And you have two options. Select the answer and submit in polling section.
60% of all the teachers have already given their answers.
Yes.
Good job. Oh, Vivek, look at this. Almost all the teachers have unanimously answered as snake.
Oh,
being the right answer.
Thank you very much, friends.
Come on, Vivek. I thought you could have got that. That was quite.
Yeah, I'm very poor at answering riddles, Sushil.
But you're good at asking riddles, aren't you?
Yes, yes.
Can you give me a few transactional ideas for similes?
Oh, sure, Tunga. To teach similes and metaphors in your classrooms or even to your daughter, Vivek, what you can do is whenever they are listening to any songs, rhymes, and poems, you can ask them to be mindful of similes and metaphors that come in that song and in that poem so that they can identify them and point it out.
Okay.
More so, when you're in a classroom scenario, you can come up with famous proverbs and sayings and then highlight those similes and metaphors that are present in famous proverbs and similes. Moreover, as a group activity, what you can do is play a game of treasure hunt. So here, you can give them clues in the form of similes and metaphors only. So what the learners have to do right now is they have to decipher the simile and metaphor and then find, only then will they be able to find the treasure, hidden treasure.
Okay.
Hey, Tunga.
Hmm?
I have a better activity for everybody right now for us to play.
Okay.
Okay. So this is called the game of let's compare.
Hmm?
As you can see, there are two lists of words. So first list is of a cat list. I call it a cat list. And the second one is a penguin list. I will give you one word from each list.
Hmm?
Then let's see if you can come up with a simile or a metaphor using those two words.
Yes, I will try.
Okay, then. Let me give you the first word as police. And the second word would be a rocket. Can you come up with some simile or a metaphor using these two words?
Okay. I think a police should have speed of a rocket in solving any case. What do you think, Sushil?
Nice. You just used a metaphor.
Yes.
Okay, very nice. If I have to use a simile, I can say that the mind of the police must be as swift as a rocket.
Yes.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. So teachers, I hope you got the rules of the game. This is how it should be played. So let us all, everybody try to play this game for one round, okay? So look at the screen, pay attention to the cat list and the penguin list. In some time, a question will appear on your screen, a poll question will appear on your screen, where you will have the four words of both cat list and penguin list. Let us all vote for one word from both the lists, and then let us play with those two words. So this is your question. So this is a cat list. These are the words from the cat list, like Johnny, police, engineer, and Rima. You can choose anyone. This is a voting question. So there is no right or wrong answer to this. You just have to vote for the word that you feel we can play with.
Yes, Sushil. Our teachers are giving Johnny. They are polling on Johnny.
Okay, so let us stop the voting now.
Yes.
Okay, so all the teachers, most of them, 39% of the teachers have voted for the word Johnny. So that's good. So let us take Johnny as our first word, shall we? Okay, so it is time to choose the second word from the penguin list. Teachers, time to vote from the penguin list. And I see there's a tie between the word tree and water. So 34% of the teachers have voted for the word water.
Water.
So let us take the word water as our second word. Okay. So here are our two words, Tunga. The
yes.
First word being Johnny and the second word being water. Thank you, teachers. Thank you for choosing those two words. So what we can do right now is just like Tunga and I played the first round. Now let us try to compare these two words using a simile or a metaphor. This time, let us all go to the chat section. And I request all teachers to come up with one sentence or two sentences which has a simile or a metaphor in it. You have to use both the words together in one sentence. Okay, Lata ma'am is already coming up with a sentence which says, Johnny is as fast as rocket.
But water, she want to use water.
Yes, so the word water is missing from the sentence. So please come up with a sentence which has Johnny and water both in the same sentence.
Johnny okay. behaves like water. Uh-huh. Chikmalaya sir is giving the answer, Johnny behaves like water.
Okay. Rashmi ma'am says, Johnny is clear as water. Uh-huh. Nice one. Oh, Johnny is as pure as water. This is a good example for simile because they are using the word as.
Yes.
Johnny speaks like flowing water. Rashmina ma'am.
Arpana is giving, Johnny is as clear as water. Good, Arpana. Johnny talks like running water.
Mm-hmm.
Fine.
A lot of similes being used.
Yes, yes. Friends, please try with a metaphor.
Bhagyama ma'am said, Johnny is running like water. Nice.
He is freaking water. Johnny is as cool like.
Teachers, let's go to the chat section and let us start typing our sentences that's there in your mind. We are all playing a game together, although we are so far away from each other.
Yes. Johnny is as dance. Sunita, Jyoti. Jyoti is giving. Yeah.
Yeah, Jyoti ma'am says, Johnny is as sweet as water.
Mm-hmm. Johnny laughs like sprinkling water. Okay.
Teachers, shall we try something beyond like and as? Shall we use a metaphor? But mind you have to compare both Johnny and water. Come out with a difference or a similarity between them. Shall we use a metaphor this time?
Narsimhurti, Johnny's smile is sound of
water. Yeah. Let us refrain from using as and like for now.
Johnny is running water. Vidya says this.
Oh, Johnny is running water. Uh-huh. Says a lot.
Yes.
Thank you, Vidya ma'am. A good metaphor to begin with. Let us all start using a metaphor for now.
Narsimhurti sir is Johnny's hot water.
Oh.
Okay. Well tried, teachers. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you, teachers. That was nice playing with you.
Let us summarize what we have learned so far. Simile is a figure of speech used to compare the similarities between two things using like or as. Whereas metaphor is also a figure of speech used to compare two unlike things using is and are.
Thank you, Kruti. Okay. Tunga, till now, I learned many things about simile and metaphor to teach my daughter. Yes. Will you please help me to learn more about personification?
Yes, Vivek.
But at the same time, I came to know that you bought a new car last week. Did you?
Yes.
Please show me that also, Tunga.
Show my car and also let you more about personification. This is my car. As you can see, the car has windshield, engine, doors, and headlight. See, this is a Lightning McQueen, which looks like car, but she has eyes, mouth, and tongue. This Lightning McQueen can smile, wink, jump, look at you, and she can also wave at you. Though both the images that we see are of cars, one of them had all the attributes of a human. It can smile, it can wink at you, it has eyes and tongue also. In totally, we can say this Lightning McQueen is a car personified because a non-living car is given human characteristics. Personification means to give human attributes to a non-human thing.
Okay, Tunga. But please teach me more about ideas to convey personification and teach my daughter.
Yes, Vivek. Here are a few transactional ideas which can be taken to class to help your learners and your daughter also. To learn about personification, we can ask learners to draw a household object colorfully and also ask them to draw eyes, hands, legs to the object and then come up with some catchy names for that object. Once they are ready with their drawings, ask them to introduce their friends and its usage to the class to make it more interesting and communicative. You can also ask your learners to explore their surroundings in the school premises and collect as many things as possible within 5 minutes. Then ask them to personify one object by drawing or pasting hands, legs, eyes to that object. This will improve their kinesthetic skill through enactment when they assume themselves to be that personified object. How would it would be to have a Franciter's competition to make the learners to learn personification?
Yes, Tunga, it sounds like a good idea. We can have a Franciter's competition where we can ask the learners to dress like any animals or things and enact in front of their friends. With the help of this activity, they can strengthen their communicative skills, and this makes them creative in thinking and executing the act.
Yes, sure, Vivek.
Let us now consolidate what we have learned about personification so far. So personification is a figure of speech which gives human characteristics to non-human objects. Teachers, now we reach our checkpoint of fun again. It's time to have fun with English. This time, we have some proverbs for you. Tunga, I have some proverbs for you, but instead of the proverb directly, I'll show you an image and I want you to identify the proverb that relates to that image.
Okay, Sushil.
So this is the first image. Teachers, please play along. What do you see, Tunga?
I see a boy with an apple and a doctor also.
So this is hinting at a famous proverb that we all know.
Yes.
Tunga, you can give your answer through the chat section so that it can reach me.
Peter? Yes, Vivek. Sorry. Sushil?
Yeah.
But I will ask my friends to give their answers in the chat box.
That friends, would be great.
Yeah. Friends, type your answer and send us through chat box.
Many teachers have already started to give their answers in the chat section.
Yes, Jyoti has given an apple a day keeps the doctor away. Fine. Neela is also giving the same.
I don't know if that is the right answer. I won't reveal it.
Okay.
Away. Let's see what others have to say.
Many of our friends are giving the same. An apple a day keeps the doctor away.
Okay. So shall I take that as answer from your side, Tunga?
Yes.
Sure. Then let us check the answer. And yes, you as well as all your friends are very much right. An apple a day keeps the doctor away was the proverb behind this image.
Thank you, friends.
Thank you, teachers. So here is the second image. Please come back to the screen and look at the second image. What do you see, Tunga?
I see a man laughing and some tablets are thrown in the dustbin, Sushil.
Yes. Teachers, again, go to the chat section now and start typing the proverb that you think is behind this image. Let us start answering for the second image now.
Yes, Sushil. Laughing is a good medicine. Vidya.
Yasmin Banu, ma'am. Yes.
Chandrakala, ma'am, is giving laughing is a good medicine. Thank you, ma'am.
Teacher, some of you are still answering to the apple a day keeps the doctor away. We have already eaten the apple now, and we are trying to take the medicines. We are on the second image, and yes, many of us are already answering. Laughing is a good medicine. Laughing is giving health. Okay. Keep the environment clean and always smile, says Hemavati ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Let's see if that
laughing
is the right answer.
Laughing is good for health, Manjula ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Laughing is the best medicine. Okay, let's see if that is the right answer.
Yes.
Let's wait for it.
Even I have a doubt, Sushil.
Yeah, Vivek, what is it?
If we keep eating apple every day, why should we take medicine?
You're right. So let us eat apple every day and keep laughing every day.
Yeah.
On that note, let's look at the answer. Let's see if all our teachers are right.
Go with your friends. Many yes. of our friends are giving. Laughter is best medicine. Laughing is the best medicine and all.
And yes, everybody is right indeed. Laughter is the best medicine. Good job, teachers. We are moving on to the next activity now. So let us all come out of the chat section. And let us look at the screens again.
Thank you, Sushil and Tunga. Tunga, yes. Come. You helped me a lot to learn pronunciation. But come, let me show you and introduce you to my new friend.
Okay. I'm curious to see your new friend.
Meet Mr. Blunder Bunny. Uh-huh. He loves carrots, but hates punctuations.
I do love carrots, Vivek.
He has a special problem with commas. Whenever he writes, he messes up with the usage of commas. Let us look at some sentences written by Blunder Bunny and help him rectify the blunders with respect to comma. Shall we?
Okay.
Here is the first sentence by a Blunder Bunny. It says, "Let us eat grandma." Blunder Bunny, do you want to eat our grandma?
No, I didn't mean that.
Yes, even I too know that, Blunder Bunny. But there is some mistake in the sentence. Friends, will you please help Blunder Bunny to identify the mistake in the sentence by putting the proper punctuation mark through a chat box?
Let us go to the chat box again and type in the sentence by placing the right punctuation mark. Okay, Meenakshi ma'am, Siddharamaya sir, Sangeeta ma'am, Sangamesh sir, many are already answering.
Yes.
And everybody suggesting the use of a comma. Mm-hmm.
Yes, many of our friends are giving and helping me a lot and helping Blunder Bunny as well, Sushil.
Yes, Vivek, you're right.
Okay then, if that is the case, yes, the prediction and answer of our friends is absolutely right. The answer is, let us eat grandma. Blunder Bunny is calling grandma to serve food. Fine, friends. Thank you. Here comes the next sentence by a Blunder Bunny. It says, it's time to eat children. Blunder Bunny, do you want to eat our children?
No. I didn't mean that.
I know, Blunder Bunny, you're too sensitive and too good. You can't eat children at all. But there is a mistake in the sentence. Friends, please help Blunder Bunny this time by using proper punctuation mark in the sentence and help Blunder Bunny to rectify the mistake. Use the chat box. Yes, many of our friends are trying to answer in the chat box. Okay, they're trying to use comma. Yes. Fine, friends. Thank you for your wonderful responses. What you are given is absolutely right. Blunder Bunny actually says, it is time to eat children. Blunder Bunny is inviting children to eat along with him. Thank you. Now comes the last sentence of our Blunder Bunny. He says, I like cooking cats and cookies, etc. Blunder Bunny, do you want to cook cats and eat?
No, I didn't mean that.
I know, Blunder Bunny, you are a pure vegetarian. You can't cook cats. But there is something mistake in the sentence. I don't know what it is about. Friends, please help Blunder Bunny for the last time
and try to correct his mistake by putting proper punctuation mark in the sentence. This is also a chat box answer. Use proper punctuation mark and help Blunder Bunny to go with the correct punctuation mark in the sentence.
Come on, teachers. We are in the third sentence now. Guess the right punctuation mark. You can use as many punctuation marks as you want, as you feel fit. Okay, we already are getting the sentences now.
Yes, Sushil.
By Fahim ma'am, Sabiba, and Jeevan Kumar, all are suggesting the use of comma.
Okay, friends. Thank you for giving your responses. Yes, you are helping our Blunder Bunny a lot.
Shall we look at the right sentence then?
Yes, Sushil. Let's go with the right sentence of our Blunder Bunny.
Teachers, let's get back to the screens. Away from chat screen now. Let's get back to the screen and look at the right answer.
Okay. Blunder Bunny wanted to say, I like cooking, cats, cookies, etc. So kind of a Blunder Bunny. Friends, here are some punctuation marks that we use in our day-to-day life while writing. They are full stop, comma, exclamation mark, question mark, parenthesis or bracket, colon. Now let us meet some punctuation marks. Meet the exclamation mark. He is a magician. He tends to shock or surprise his audience by his tricks. Hence, when you see him in a sentence, you are in for a surprise. Now meet the punctuation mark, question mark. He is always puzzled. He is very inquisitive about anything and everything. So whenever you see him in a sentence, you ought to give an answer for him. Meet Mr. Full Stop. He is a very strict police officer. Whenever you see him in a sentence, you better stop. Meet comma. She is a timid and shy punctuation mark. Whenever you see her crossing the road, please pass and wait until she crosses the road. Whenever you see in a sentence, please pass and wait till she uses and then complete the sentence. Friends, here are some transactional ideas to help improve punctuation marks. These ideas can be used in the classroom. The first idea is, on the top of each stick, paste one punctuation mark. Give some sentences on the board without any punctuation marks in it. You can teach the learners the appropriate usage of the sentence and also evaluate their understanding by asking them to place the punctuation marks wherever it is required. Tunga, come, I'll show you how to play this. Okay. If I give you a sentence, stop painting Nisha, what punctuation mark are you going to use?
Use exclamation mark.
Oh, fine, Tunga. Good. We use exclamation mark for the sentence. Let me give you another example. If I select a sentence, will Govind eat, what punctuation mark will you use?
Use question mark today.
Very good, Tunga. Friends, this idea can be continued in the same manner. Here is the next transaction idea to teach punctuation mark. It is called punctuation pockets. Each pocket will be called by the assigned punctuation mark, like comma pocket, full stop pocket, etc. Create certain sentences without a particular punctuation mark. Ask your learners to find out the missing punctuation and place the sentence in that respective order. Now, Tunga, If I select a sentence, will Govind eat, and ask you to put the proper punctuation and in a pocket, which one will you select?
I will select question mark pocket, Vivek. I will put the sentence in the question mark pocket.
Very good, Tunga. You're absolutely right. In the same manner, we can continue by playing this game in the classroom, friends. Now let us watch a video. The video is called Kung Fu Punctuation, which helps us to familiarize punctuations in a creative manner in the classroom.
Welcome to Kung Fu Punctuation. Capital letter.
Capital letter.
Capital letter.
Capital letter.
Full stop.
Full stop.
Comma. Comma. Colon. Colon. Semicolon. Semicolon. Question mark. Question mark. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Speech marks. Speech marks. Apostrophe. Apostrophe. Brackets. Brackets.
Capital letter.
Capital letter.
Well done.
Friends, hope you all enjoyed the video. Just as shown in the video, you can familiarize the punctuation marks to your learners by associating the actions with each punctuation marks. Thank you, everyone.
Let us now consolidate what we have learned in the section of punctuations. So we have learned that a punctuation mark completes the sentence, because mind you, a sentence is not considered complete until it has a punctuation mark in it. A punctuation mark also conveys the emotion of the sentence by expressing shock, surprise, etc. A punctuation mark also clarifies the meaning of the sentence, because we have seen if you don't clarify the meaning, our condition will be like our blunder bunny. Thus, we reach the end of this session. Till now, we have discussed on the topics of phonics, punctuations, simile, metaphor, and personification. I wish all the teachers have enjoyed our discussions and as well the creative activities. These are the learning outcomes that these discussions and activities actually cater to. These learning outcomes are grade specific and taken for each grade. These are the learning outcomes for the grades of 4th and 5th. Here are the learning outcomes for the grade 6th and 7th. These learning outcomes tie up directly with the activities that we have discussed today. And these are the list of chapters that these activities cater to and these learning outcomes cater to. You can find the connection between the learning outcomes and the activities discussed with these chapters listed out. For the grades of 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th, under these concepts of phonics, punctuations, and figures of speech, that is simile and metaphor, and personification. It is now time for us to take feedback from all our dear participant teachers. I call upon Dhatri to continue with the feedback session, and I also thank all these sources for lending their creative and useful resources for this session to happen.
Thank you, Sushil. Thank you so much. ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ. ನಾವು ತುಂಬಾ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಅಲ್ವೇ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ದಿನ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ನನ್ನ ಇಷ್ಟು ಫನ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿವೇಕ್ ಸರ್, ತುಂಗಾ ಮ್ಯಾಡಮ್, ಕೃತಿ, ಸುಶೀಲ್, ನಿಸರ್ಗ, ಶ್ರೀದೇವಿ, ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ.